Let's talk now about classes. So to become object-oriented. So classes in Python are very similar to any other classes. So the ideas of classes that they are contain functions and variables. Functions and variables. So they're a bit like a tuple, but in this case, in this case, a tuple not just contains variables but also functions. So we have something like a container, and there inside we have function one and function two, and then we have variable one, two, and so on and so on, and then this is here called a class. The class itself is not directly something which can be used, so the class then needs to be instantiated. So you can create different instances of this class than in the program. So then this becomes here instance one, and then this here becomes instance two, and they're just essentially again variables. So the variables containing then this class here. So that's a variable, and that's also a variable here again, and so on. And so we can create different instances of that. So that's all very abstract. So we need to go. The best way of approaching classes is again by example, because otherwise it's quite hard to see how this all works. And there are some couple of special things in Python which don't show up in other programming languages when you're defining classes. Okay, so we start with the keyboard class, and then we just define the name of our class here after white space. Let's say here my amazing class, and then again we are writing a colon here just to start the class. So now let's define functions here. So with the variables we're coming back a bit later. So let's define a function like def and then do math. So now there's something which is special in Python here. The first argument in a class, in a function in a class, needs to be always start with self, and then after the self we can add our function arguments here. So let's call this here a. And then again our colon here. So let's do some math. Let's say b equals to a multiplied by 10, and then we return the result of b as a function here. And then obviously we can define more functions here, def and so on. So let's have a look if this works. So I've cleared this here all out. So let's define our function class my amazing class colon. So now we're getting the indent here. So I do def do math. So we define this function here, and remember this is now self comma a with the argument. Again, here spider automatically indents that, and then we do b equals to b multiplied by 10 to do a bit of math, and then we return this b here. Okay, so this is undefined. Oh, that's not b here, that's a, of course. Okay, so warning sign gone. So class definition is fine. So we could define obviously more functions here. So I could also do def do more math. Again, remember self, comma a as an argument here. So you can imagine you're creating a class with doing all different kinds of trigonometric functions, for example, and you could then keep them nicely together regarding this. So we multiply by 20 here and return b. Yeah, warning sign is gone. Okay, so now we have created this class here. So now the question is, now how do we use this class in the main program? So now we would like to obviously use it in a certain way, and that's very easy. So we need to instantiate this class. So if I just quickly move that away here, and so the idea is, so that's the definition of the class, and then we instantiate the class. And this is very simple in Python. So we just write, for example, if that's in our class equals to my amazing class. So with that you are creating an instance of the class. Obviously, if you want to have another instance of this doing something separate, you could also write f2 and then doing again the same. This obviously doesn't make much sense because that's still doing the same, but we could put something in here, and we do it a bit later in explaining how we can use this argument to make this class different to the other one. So let's go first back to Spider here. So we create an instance of that here. F equals my amazing class, and create this instance here. And and now we do a bit of mathematics here. So we say F dot, and now we see here Spider offers already the function of the class, which is quite a nice helper function. So let's do math, and it wants to have an argument. It also knows that, and put a 5 in it, and then we print this here out. So let's put this here together, because that's our main program, and let's save it and run it. Okay, so then we're getting the 50 there. Obviously, what we can do here, we've got the other function. Let's call this here x2 and call this here do more mass, which already offered here. Let's put let's put a 7 in there and print x2. Yeah, so we see here 50 and 140. So with that we're seeing that these two different functions are called. So that's all fine. So let's just go back here to the scribbling, and let's have a look what can be done about this here. So if you want to create initialized classes with different values, so if you want to create variables, so let's look now at constructors in classes. So what is a constructor? Constructor is a special function which is called when the class is created or instantiated. Yeah, so that's a special function which is called when when the class is instantiated. So remember, in the in this program here, so f equals my amazing class. So there's this bracket here, and so in this bracket we can put values in there, which are then transmitted into the class here when this is created here and creating this f here. Yeah, so we can initialize this class here with special values, and this is done in the so-called constructor. Yeah, so we need to create a special function which is doing this initialization process here. And so the definition of the constructor is the following. So therefore, if we have again class my amazing class, again, so the colon, and now we define a special function def, and then space underscore underscore init, and then again self comma, and then let's say coefficient. There are also two underscores here. So this init here, this defines our constructor function. So in this init function, now we can initialize variables, for example. So we can say self dot so the answer to all questions is obviously 42, and so we can create a variable which has a value 42. And what we also can do is here, so we can save these coefficients here transmitted into this class here into a local variable. So let's call this here my coefficients, and we assign this here to the from this argument here. So we see, so the constructor has a purpose to initialize variables, and it also has a purpose to save these arguments from the constructor into here instance variables, which are then can be used throughout the class, throughout the lifetime of the class. So these are instance variables here. So let's try this out in our demo code here. Are we there? So here let's create a constructor def underscore underscore init and underscore, so there are also two underscores here. I messed it slightly up here, yeah, so don't be confused. So that's two underscores here init, and then self comma, and then let's call this here coefficient. So that's our constructor. And so now here we can now create variables, for example self, let's call this here 10 and put a 10 in it. And so, and therefore here, instead of b equals a multiplied by 10, I could now also write self dot 10. So we have a variable. So we see already Spider is already offering this here in a convenient way. So you see there's a lot of class support in Spider, which is nice and forcing you to do proper coding within classes. So now the other thing is here, so we've got this argument coefficient here, and this argument comes from here. So therefore, whatever we put in here, so let's say a 9, this 9 will show up then here as a coefficient. But in order to use it in the other functions, we need to save this. So let's say here save my coefficient, and we putting the function, the constructor argument into that. And so now what we can do is here, so we could say that, so we've got here the a, that's 10, then the variable a, then we've got the self 10, and then just to make it a bit more complex, we multiply this here with self dot coefficient. And here, we just multiply the a with our self dot coefficient here. And this is here wrong, because that is self dot my coefficient. So let's hope that I've done no mistake. But the Python environment will tell me this. No, I haven't done this. Okay, so let's check if this is correct here, the 450. So how do we get this 450? We could just debug it in the way that we calculate this here by hand, because we have got the console next to us. Yeah, so the first 450 here, this is done by do math 5. So the argument is 5. And then that's just transmitted to do math here. That's a 5. And then the self dot 10. 10 is we assigned, luckily with 10, not to confuse ourselves. And then the self my coefficient here comes from the constructor. And the constructor here is 9. Yeah, and that's luckily 450, so that's working. And then the other argument here is 63. So here we have got, so the argument A, so the argument A here is 7. And the argument A, so the 7 we multiply with my coefficient here, and my coefficient was 9. And that's 63, what we had here at the output here. So you see also the command line is very convenient to debug programs, and you can also copy and paste fragments of your program into the console here and try it out.